Hi, I'm Paul Schinkel with Eurotherm by Schneider Electric. Today we wanted to put together a video of really a roundtable with some of our industry experts in heat treatment. I wanted to start off introducing Peter Sherwin. He's our Global Business Development Lead for heat treatment. We also have Joseph Clark, North America Business Development Manager in heat treatment and digital offerings. And we also have Chris Mooney, North America Sales Manager. What we wanted to really discuss briefly was just, you know, equipment efficiency and then how that relates to Industry 4.0. So, you know, I've been hearing a lot about IoT, IIoT, Industry 4.0. You know, why should we all really care about Industry 4.0?
Well, Paul, I think I can probably take that one. I've done a couple of presentations on this, so it's kind of fresh in my mind here. But basically, the whole term, you know, Industry 4.0 is really referring to the next major shift or the next industrial revolution in the manufacturing process. And really the whole concept behind Industry 4.0 is really about having a greater push for connectivity, smarter automation, and better data exchange. You know, when you look at furnaces and ovens from 10 to 15 years ago, they were still being built, or at least at a minimum, using paper chart records. And if there was communication, there might be some communication between a PLC and a temperature controller, but it pretty much stopped there. Today, you've got sensors and various edge devices that are being built with various communication mediums, like your RJ45, your Bluetooth, and they're supporting multiple protocols. So when you take that with the right solutions, then you can start doing some really interesting stuff, like having the ability to remotely have insight into your process. If you're collecting data on various sensors or various components of the furnace, then you can start to contribute to more of a predictive maintenance strategy. Similarly, if you look at some of the other technologies out there, you can start to improve things like machine learning, where you can actually, utilizing AI, really start to determine where some of the inefficiencies are in your various cycles, which can help to reduce cycle time. But also the AI built in can also be used to do machine learning in the sense that it will start to learn how your machine or how your furnace functions over time. And the more that it learns, the smarter it's going to be, ultimately residing in the fact that if there's a small change in your system, you have the ability to alert the relevant people via email and text and so on and so forth. And, you know, the real first introduction that I had with Industry 4.0 was probably about 5 or 6 years ago, but it's really heavily been talked about in the last 1 to 2 years. And I think that really kind of comes down to probably two main reasons. The first one is that the technology being used today, it's evolving continuously. So things like the edge devices, the portable electronics, cloud services, that's all becoming more readily available, and it's also becoming substantially more cost effective. So now consumers can actually implement this technology without worrying about breaking the bank. But I think the other aspect behind it as well is the fact that those who are actually implementing these technologies to make their factory smart are of a younger generation. We're going through a change now where the older generations, the baby boomers, are starting to retire. And we've got the millennials, and I think probably even to a point, Gen Z coming in, and they're accustomed and used to this technology. So if they're accustomed to it, they're in positions where they're influencing or can actually authorize these changes within their facility, they're going to go down that route. And I think really those are the two reasons why we're starting to really hear a lot about Industry 4.0 and why we all should care about how important it is.
Absolutely. Absolutely.
And just to add to that, I think many manufacturing companies have kind of exhausted activities in lean manufacturing and gone as far as they can in quality control and SPC. So really, I see this helping unlock what's called the hidden factory and using KPIs like OEE.
Yep.
Yeah, you know, just one last comment, and that's that, you know, as Joe said, the concept and philosophy of Industry 4.0 and IIoT, you know, that it really came around, you know, 5-6 years ago, but really in the last year, 2 years, the solutions have become more robust. They've become more off the shelf, sort of ready to go, rather than having to invest a lot of money in complicated development and in-house development. So the cost for implementation and the payback is much more attractive than it's ever been in the past.
I see. So you guys, you did kind of touch on some things, you know, some examples from a broad perspective, but what are some real, drill down to really, you know, Industry 4.0 in action, specific examples? Do you have anything to add there?
Yeah, I think I'll take this one, Paul. Okay. So if I look at a commercial heat treater and think about the flow from the parts coming into the factory, which are obviously delivered by truck, we're not there yet with autonomous vehicles external to the plant, but certainly there are some smart vehicles, so they can be passing information into the plant, which can help the production plan. Then once you get the parts on site, you have to go through a contract review. So actually having data that can mesh with the internal database system to make sure that you can actually get accurate details for the production work instructions, I think that's becoming more and more important, and companies are investing the time to sort of link up data solutions. Then if you get to the internal transport, sort of moving parts around the factory, you're already seeing this in warehouses where you've got these autonomous vehicles that are just operating. So you don't have to take someone out of production and have them use forklifts or pallet trucks to sort of move parts around. You can just rely on these autonomous little vehicles that are jotting around the factory floor. Then I think the next stage is looking at the jigging and the fixturing, where you're putting the parts together in a fixture to go into the hot temperature, high temperature furnace. And then the ability to use cobots to actually help that jigging and fixturing solution. And you move then to things like what it's termed as augmented work. And sort of this is helping process efficiency. So using augmented reality and mixed reality to help from the training aspect to get people more sort of up to speed and quicker in using the equipment and the furnaces, all the way through to the ability to monitor the furnace and the status using augmented reality techniques, as well as helping the maintenance operation with AR solutions. And then once you're running the process, actually having solutions that help you keep that uptime of the furnace. So that's definitely down the AI and the predictive maintenance route. Once you've got the parts outside of the furnace, you're looking at the inspection side of things. Now there's a push in bringing all of that quality information together. So kind of termed as big data quality, to sort of see where there are potential advantages to improve that process capability. I mean, the nirvana ultimately is getting to self-organizing production. If you've got this equipment that really understands its own status and can talk to other equipment, other devices, other people, etc., and pull that together as a network, then you can start to get the equipment itself to self-organize. I mean, this is not there yet, but it will come there in the future. So if you've got a potential breakdown on one furnace, it automatically routes everything to another line. And obviously the thing that pulls all of this together, because you're using data from all sorts, whether it's sort of on-premise, at the edge, or in the cloud, you need to have a very good cybersecurity structure.
Sure. Thanks, Peter. Does anybody have anything else to add to that? No? Okay. Well, you know, I think when it comes down to it, people, you know, they understand the concept of IoT Industry 4.0. It makes sense. Everybody wants to go, you know, no paper, but really have the big data analytics and all of those things that'll help. But, you know, how it does seem like it could be a very daunting task to get from A to B. I mean, how can a heat treater get started?
Yeah, Paul, I'll take that one. Well, to be honest with you, the simplest way is just to begin small. You know, oftentimes you get the idea that maybe this needs to be some big capital project, you know, that's going to take weeks and months and, you know, cost overruns, et cetera, things like that. But the reality is, you know, with a lot of these solutions, you can start small, utilizing sort of entry level or introductory packages, demo environments, and then growing the infrastructure and the interconnectivity based on need and capability. For example, Eurotherm, we have our instrument SCADA software platform, which is essentially a SCADA software. SCADA is supervisory control and data acquisition, gives you the opportunity to connect to your Ethernet connected controls, your power controls, your gas flow meters, things like that. Gives you a central point for monitoring, a central point for recipe management, a central point for alarm management, so you can have easier, faster reaction time to interruptions in production. You start with a smaller entry-level software platform like the Eurotherm instrument SCADA, and then scale over time. Look for solutions which are more modular, based on the needs of the business. If you have a need to, you want to start looking at different ways to modernize your compliance capabilities, you start with something like our instrument SCADA, and then move into incorporating something like the MCA or Manufacturing Compliance Advisor, which is a new cloud-based compliance tool that Eurotherm offers. If you want to look more at utilization, how are you getting the most efficiency out of the heat treat assets in your plant? You want to know things like uptime, planned downtime, unplanned downtime. You want to know reasons why equipment has gone down and categorize that in under unplanned downtime. You look at an OEE solution, which can be bolted on and sort of modularized to an instrument SCADA platform. You want to know more about operational efficiency. So, how much energy are you using to run these batches? Is it a gas-fired furnace, an electrically heated furnace? Is it a molten sodium salt bath where you have that's electrically heated, and you want to know, how much energy is it actually taking you to run that batch? We have things like the Eurotherm, the Schneider Electric PME or Power Monitor Expert platform, which can bolt on to our instrument SCADA. So really the easiest way and the simplest way is to start small, maybe scope out sort of a long-term direction where you want to go. And then implement in phases, in stages, in sort of a modular concept.
Wow.
Okay. So I think just to add to that, have a goal, get a plan together, and just try it. There's a lot of offers out there. So discuss with a number of suppliers. Obviously, come to us. We can give you some advice about this and how to mesh some of these solutions in with regulatory requirements. But I think the caution I would add is avoid trying to create a lot of different solutions, and then you've got these isolated data islands, which will be more difficult to connect in the future.
No, that clears it up. I mean, that helps me out a lot. I think it's a very interesting topic with Industry 4.0 and the fourth industrial revolution. So, but sometimes I think there's a lot of questions about what it really is. Thanks for watching our video, guys. If you want to continue the conversation with any one of these experts, they're going to be at the booth, the virtual booth in the chat. Love to go over this stuff and answer any of your questions or, like I said, discuss it further. So thanks again and take care.